Let's make soft pretzels. It's actually very easy to do. There are a few steps, but they're each quite easy to do. So first we need a large bowl. We need 4.5 cups of flour, 1 tablespoon of salt. We're gonna mix the salt and the flour together and kind of hide the salt. If yeast and salt touch each other, it will stop the yeast from working as well as it could. So you never wanna mix the salt and the water with the yeast. Always mix it with the flour and hide it. Okay, so that's done. Then in another bowl I have 1 tablespoon of sugar and 2¼ teaspoons of yeast. And that's the same equivalent to 1 packet of yeast. And you also want to have ready some oil. 2 tablespoons of oil. Okay, let's talk about the water. So it's really important to activate the yeast and not kill the yeast. You need to have it nice, cozy temperature. It's like warm, too hot, that area. If your measuring thing is cold, put some hot water in it first and warm up your measuring cup, because it's really surprising how fast the temperature can change and go down. I've got 1½ cups of water. Spoon ready, my yeast and sugar. Let's add that in. And it's so cool when the yeast activates, you'll see. It's just really amazing. So I'm gonna let that help. So the sugar is there to feed the yeast. Once it activates and wakes up, it needs to eat. So you can use honey, you can use any kind of sugar. You just need that there to help them grow. And remember, do not add your salt into this. Your yeast won't work as much and as powerfully as it could if you do. So I just want to show you this because it's so cool. Isn't that cool? So you know your yeast is healthy and alive, and you know the water was the right temperature. Okay, so we know that the yeast is ready. I'm just gonna give that another stir so it doesn't stick to it when I pour it out. And right into our bowl. Okay, and I added my 2 tablespoons of oil. Okay, so I'm gonna start with a spoon and mix it all together. That's as far as I'm gonna go with a spoon. So I'm gonna clean the spoon off and then we can start kneading it together. Now you might feel like, oh, this is never gonna come together. It feels really dry and really sticky, like at the same time. But keep going, I promise you it's gonna work out. And the dough will soon turn into a nice, beautiful dough. You want to make pretzels for Grandma and Grandpa when they come?
Grandma?
Yeah, when they come over, we'll give them our pretzels.
Grandma?
Grandma? They're coming over today. They'll be here for lunch. What are you doing? Coming today.
Grandma?
Uh-huh.
A grandpa?
Yes.
Grandma? A grandpa?
Yeah, they're coming around lunchtime.
Grandma? Grandma? Mommy?
Yes, Grandma. For 10 minutes. It's really fun. Like, you want to just keep playing with it. It feels a lot like Play-Doh now. So the trick also you can do is rip off a chunk, and we're going to do what they call the window pane method. So you're going to stretch it thin, as thin as you can. Like, you're going to make a little screen. Hopefully it's bright enough over here that you can see. You see that? You can see through. You can see light through it. So that's how we know we've kneaded enough. The gluten's developed, it's strong and stretchy. You're gonna tuck it under like this. Tucking it under. Tuck it under, tuck it under. Like that. Just pinch it together like that. Okay, see? Alright, so now it's nice and smooth. That's so crazy how a few minutes of work and you've turned it to something different. So we're gonna take some oil again. That was about a tablespoon of oil. And I'm just gonna put it in there. I put it around the bowl, then I'm gonna put it in. I'm gonna roll this around. And it's okay that the bowl is not completely clean. That's fine. Okay, so we're gonna take it, roll it around in the dough first, and then roll it around the bowl a little bit. So now it's nice and beautiful, and it's not going to stick to my bowl. I'm going to cover it with a, you can cover it with saran wrap, but it won't stick to this bowl. If you're going to use saran wrap, you need a glass bowl, FYI. But I'm just going to use a clean kitchen towel. I'm going to cover it. And so a good trick is to turn on the light of your oven, wherever your light switch is. So the light is on. And I'm just gonna stick it in there. Do not turn your oven on. We're just gonna stick it in there And the light will actually produce enough heat to keep it warm and cozy. See? Oh, there we go. I'm gonna leave it there for about an hour. Just in case I forget how long mine is. Okay, let's take a look. Look how beautiful that is. So there's a trick where you can push your finger in up to your first knuckle. And then if you watch it, and if it doesn't move a lot, then you know the dough is ready. If it closes right away, then it's not done rising. It's a super cool trick. So it's staying the same, so we know the dough is ready to go. It's like a little bed. This is so cool. So we just want to push the air out. You can hear the air leaving. Okay. So now that that's come out, we're going to preheat our oven. We want 450. Middle rack. Leave that there. You also need to have ready a large pot, and this is 10 cups of water. So I've got half a cup of baking soda. We're going to add that to the water. Now with this dough, you can get 8 large pretzels or 16 small ones, like medium ones, and I'll show you what that looks like. And here is one of the smaller. So you can get 16 like this size, or you can get 8 of them this size. So for 8 pretzels, just cut it down that way, cut it that way, okay? And then if you want 16, then just cut them one more time. They're like little pillows. They're so soft and full of air. The dough worked perfectly. Okay, so I'm gonna do 3 large ones. So let's start going. Hopefully you can see. So just like if you're playing with Play-Doh and you're gonna roll out a snake. Okay, so for the smaller ones, so if you, for me, this is 6 inches. If I measure 1, 2, 3, I know that's 18. So that's good enough. For the little ones, it's gonna be that. About 16 to 18. Then you make a little U shape like this, put one over like that, and cross it over the second time. So you want 2 crossings, and then grab it and fold it down. There you go. And then you just want to push it down and push it down. So I have, you can use parchment paper on cookie sheets, but I just picked up these silicone pads, so I'm just going to put this here while I keep making them. If you want to do a pretzel twist, you can just take, so I rolled it out like normal. So this is 1, 2, this is like 15 inches. And then you just put it together. It's really easier with one hand, with 2 hands. One hand holds here while the other one twists it around. I'm just gonna twist these together at the end. See? Okay, and if you want to do pretzel bites, I rolled it out so it's almost 18 inches, about 18 inches, and I'm just going to do like a couple inch pieces. Okay, just like that, and we're going to put them on a tray. So for pretzel bites, that's what that's going to be like. So here's the pretzel bites. They puffed up. They're so perfect looking. Look at those guys. And here's our twist. Okay, so now I just have a few more to make. I'm going to turn on my water. I'm the super high with the lid. So if it's getting harder to roll, like it's really slippery, it's just because of the oil from the dough. So if you just get a wet towel and wipe it down and rinse your hands off, then it will be easier again to grip the dough and have it roll out. Because I'm having to do that too. So for the larger ones, you want this to be about 30 inches long, obviously, because it's the other ones are half the size. So I'm just going to measure. So this is 6 inches, remember. So we can 6, 12, 18, 24, and a little bit. So I'm almost there. I'll shape it out a little bit longer. But it's not like an exact science. It doesn't matter.
Don't hit the faces. No, faces are off.
So this is easier because it's bigger, right? So you have that, and you take one, fold it over. And then you take this one, and you fold it over. And then you grab them both, and pull them down. Just like that. I'm just gonna push this down. And push this down. You need some kind of a thing to dip them and to take them back out of the water. So, and then a place to let them drip and get off the water. I have a cookie sheet and I'm gonna put down aluminum foil so that it keeps my counter clean. I hope you can hear me. We have guests over, so it's a little loud. So we have one egg beaten for the egg wash. I also have some coarse salt. They're bigger pieces of salt, you can tell. So they didn't have pretzel salt in my store. I couldn't find it. So I just got this and that works perfectly. So this is important. If you leave it too long in this solution, it's gonna taste like metal. I know other people, they'll say 30 seconds one side, 30 seconds another side. It's way too much time and they taste like metal when you eat them. So what my trick is, you hold it under the water for 15 seconds max and you count it out every time. And if it helps, you can do the 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, and you hold it under the water. And when you get to 15, take it out and you're done and put it on there to cool. So this is the secret, because it will ruin the pretzels so much if you put them in the water for too long. But you need this because it will give them that chewy softness that pretzels have. So this is an important step. So this is almost up to a boil, which is close enough for me. So what I do, I put my pretzel on the spoon, and then I'm just gonna drop this down and count 15, 3, 4, 5 Mississippi, 6 Mississippi, 7 Mississippi, 8 Mississippi, 9 Mississippi, 10 Mississippi, 11 Mississippi, 12 Mississippi, 13 Mississippi, 14, 15. So 15 seconds max, completely submerged. Take it out and put it on here to dry off. Okay, now that I have enough that fills up my cookie sheet, I'm gonna put these on the free one. And you can touch them, they're just kind of slimy. You can also move them around if you want them to look different. Okay. And I just turned this off for me so I can get this done. And I know it'll heat back up soon. Okay, so we're gonna do the egg wash.
He's trying to trick you. He didn't take your key. He missed it. He was telling that because you couldn't see it.
And then just salt to taste how much you think. But because we did flavor the dough, you don't need like a super amount of salt. So this is going to be a very individual thing.
There's one.
Just pop them in. So the middle rack. Okay, so we're going to do 10 minutes. So it's 10 to 12 minutes, but no more than 12. So 10 minutes for me is perfect, 10, 11. So just keep an eye on it when it gets really close. I'm gonna turn this back up and keep going. Okay, so I did the pretzel bites, I did two at a time in the water and let them dry and put them on. So they're ready. And these are just a minute to go, but we'll peek in and see. Look how beautiful they are. They're so pretty. It's so easy to do. I have just a couple more that are left over. Look it! Look how beautiful they are! This is so easy to do and they look so amazing! Should we peek at the other side? Look it! That's nice. Can you see? Sometimes on camera it looks darker than it is, but it's beautiful brown. Okay, so you can melt some butter and then brush it on, but I don't have that. So I'm just gonna take some butter. And just a little bit of butter, because it's gonna get hot and fall off. So you just want a little bit on the knife. Otherwise you're gonna lose a huge amount of butter, it'll fall right off. So just do a little bit until you have what you want.